Now this is my piece of wood to go in my left hand end. What I've got here, don't know if you can see it, marked. I'm going to put a circle, cut a circle here, and a square in the middle. Now that's I can put my beer bottles in there, my oils. Do that, I just grabbed a couple of bottles. And I just marked around, made the square one. I'm going to make that a bit bigger because it's a 750ml bottle, and there's a good chance I want to put a liter bottle in there. So I'm just making it a bit bigger and doing it symmetrical. So square, square in the middle, circle either side, 70ml circles, and that's 90 square. With my square hole cut, I'm now going to do my round holes on the bench drill here. I can't video it because every time I try and video using this thing, the camera just cuts out. So I'll drill my hole there and there, and then I can just sand her up and put her in place. Not too shabby. So I've added a board underneath there, and now I am going to oil what I've done so far, just because I'm not going to be able to move this if I complete it too much more. It's bloody heavy already, so I'm not going to be able to get around there, so I'm going to oil what I've got and then get it round, and I'll build the rest in situ. So that's the carcass of my storage area on the barbecue. So that there. Will fit in this area here. So this area here will be a cupboard, and that's the framework that will support it all. Right, time to cut this piece of granite. Now, I'm cutting through here. Just got a few bits of tape there to help stop chipping the edge, hopefully, and protect the surface from the saw base. There's my guide. And I'm gonna cut it with the trusty Hitachi C18DL that I've had for years that gets all the shit jobs now. The fibro cutting, stone cutting, all the shit jobs. So I don't damage my good stuff. So I've got a Makita segmented diamond blade on there, so it doesn't need water. And I'm gonna give this a crack, see how she goes. Thank you. Well, that looks pretty good. I'm happy with that. That's nice and smooth. So I'll carry on doing the other cups. So it's cut. I'll just give her a bit of a clean, see how she comes up. Next I have to put in my granite. As if this thing wasn't already heavy enough. Granite in. I need a piece down here of timber. I'm gonna strip along the front and back. Now I've got these spring hinges for my door. Pretty simple door. I've got it in there nice and tight so that it'll stay down hopefully like that when I pull it down. And when I pull it up, it'll keep it up. So, just need to cut out some gaps for the hinges and that will go on there like so. Haven't really decided what sort of handle I want on the front of my little door, so I'm going to cut one out of this. It may just be a temporary one, but I'll probably end up leaving it there. Just going to cut that, screw it on the inside so it overlaps over the top and out the front, and I can pull it on. So with my piece of steel cut for the lid, I'm now going to cut a piece of fibro the same size that will go on top of that. I'll attach those together with screws, and then on top of the fibro I will be putting Vitex so that it matches the top of the rest of the barbecue. So I'll cut that now. Now that I've attached my fibro via these four screws in the corners to the core tin, I will now put this piece of angled core tin through the middle. I've drilled a 10mm hole in that, which will become apparent why I've done that shortly. So now I'm going to attach that to the middle, and that will give the support so it doesn't warp, and also the hole will come in handy on it shortly. Now these are the bits of tin from my top. I've just set them in there just to test they fit. So that's the design of that. Unfortunately it won't be sitting flush like that, because I need to make it fireproof. And I can't be bothered trying to get real thin Vitex to stick on the top of the steel, so I've made top with the steel and the fibro, and then this will go on top of that, and it'll just sit proud by about 10mm, so unfortunately, 11.5mm, I think. So it, such is life. Thank you. So, just got someone to give me a hand to get the barbecue into its final position. And it's a long weekend here in New Zealand, and I want to get the thing cranked. So, I need to cut me some plates and get it finished off. So I've got these old barbecue grill plates, which I just need to cut down. So I'll do that, and they'll be my top plates. And it's quite good because it leaves a bit of a gap that I can fire wood in, or coal, whichever. If I have one over to the side like that, one on that side, I can still fire wood underneath if I needed to. With that done, I need to just now do a plate at the bottom that my coals will sit on. Now we have one of these little Weber numbers. I've made this one so that this lid will fit on like so, so that I can smoke things on that end, and I'll just have flat plates on there so that the heat all shoots up underneath here. Then that's where I will, what I'll use for small smoking things. Now for the bottom grill, I don't really like how spacious this is. Just the ash just falls through too fast for my liking. So I want something a bit more solid on the barbecue I'm building. Because yeah, like I say, they just fall through and into the bottom, and it's a little bit annoying. So I think I'm gonna make one out of a piece of plate, and I'll just cut some holes in it for a bit of air to get through. There'll also be plenty of air getting around the sides of it, because I won't make it right across. It'll be a bit of an experiment. So I'm gonna go make that now. Kind of a windy here, but hopefully you can hear me. This bit here sticking out the side conveniently is 390 wide, which is exactly what I want for my Barbie, and it's just over 500 long, which isn't as long as the barbecue is wide, but I need a gap around it anyway for the airflow and stuff, so this should do nicely. So as you can see, I've drawn up a bit of a pattern on my plate here, and I'm going to drill some holes to let a bit of air through for the coals, I'm going to start off doing a pilot hole, 3.5 mil, and then I'll probably do 10 mil holes or maybe 8 mil, whatever I feel like at the time. Good. This drill was behaving funny on me the other day. It was cutting in and out, and I didn't know whether it was the batteries or what it was. Now she's smoking like crazy, and I'm doing that much to it. I think I've just fried it. Oh, look at that. Pulling the trigger and it's making it smoke. But nothing's even happening. That ain't good. It's weird. Better get the battery off this thing, my burst in flames. Look at it. Hopefully you can see that on the camera. Whew. She's smoking up a storm. Yikes. I'm gonna get that battery off. So it's time to light this puppy up, see if all this work's been worth it, or whether it's all going to go up in flames. So I have four of these fuel camping tablet things. I'm going to light in the bottom, and then build my fire on top of that. And I'm using Vitex Hardwood offcuts from my deck, and from making all this. It burns very hot. Very windy. Not a good night to do it around. Fucking hell. those trousers on my. Hopefully this lights these bloody fuel cell things. Got wind! Looks like it might have lit the fuel tablet at least. And then I went and did that. How not to build a fire. All this paper blowing around. Why I use those tabs in the first place. But it is extremely windy at the moment. Not a good night to test it, but that's bloody spring weather in New Zealand for you. I think we're going to be underway this time. Fingers crossed. Speed up the camera. Nearly ready to chuck some food on. So there's a bit of heat there now, she's ready to go. It's been about half an hour, I suppose. And I don't know how the rest of the world does it, but down here, this is how I check that the grill's ready to go. Not too much, but anyway, look at that little beer pipelet. He is ready to go. Kiwis and Aussies cook with beer on their barbies quite a lot, and you can't have a barbecue without beer. So, I think I'll go grab some meat. There's no vegan bloody sausages for this fucking barbecue. Now I'm christening her with some pork slices, which is a bit unusual for me. I was going to use steak. We've got some good steaks there, but I'm going to save them for tomorrow. And tonight I'm going to have pork slices, so let's chuck them on. Sounds nice and hot. So that's me signing out for this project. Thanks for watching. If you haven't already, please subscribe, like. Feel free to comment below, tell me what you like about it, tell me what you don't like about it, and I'll see you on the next video. Thanks for watching. Look, next to nothing in the ash front. That's it. Fuck it all.